Welcome to our carol service for today from the Ingleborough team of churches. I'm glad you could join us for this special Advent and Christmas carol service. My name is Reverend Nick Trenholme, the team vicar in our churches. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome. If you'd like to join us again, if you enjoyed what you see here in this service, then please do subscribe as well. In this service, we are modelling the service on a traditional service of lessons and carols, slightly shorter than the 9 lessons and carols, which is famous from King's College in Cambridge. We're going to have 5 readings today, one from each of our parishes, and a range of carols to sing along to as well. There's lots of Christmas events and services, of course, taking place in our churches. Do check out our website for all the details of what's coming up in person and also online as well. But I'd like to begin with a traditional opening for carol services modelled on that service I mentioned at King's College in Cambridge. So let's hear these traditional words of inviting us to reflect again on the Christmas story and beginning in prayer. Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmastide our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God, from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, for unity and brotherhood within the church he came to build, and especially in the places we live, the churches and the Christians we worship with, the communities we live among and serve. And because this, of all things, would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore, and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are forever one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us, saying the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May the Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all. Amen. Let's now turn to our first carol.
Thank you. Adam and Eve have eaten the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree from which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all the livestock and all the wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel."
I'm reading from the book of the prophet Micah, chapter 5. "But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origins is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labour has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace."
Thank you. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. "The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God of us, God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until after she gave birth to a son, and he gave her the name Jesus.
And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning all that had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, and his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
I want to start sharing these few thoughts by reading a poem to you. It's by Alfred Lord Tennyson, and it's a poem particularly for Christmas time. The time draws near, the birth of Christ. The moon is hid, the night is still, the Christmas bells from hill to hill answer each other in the mist. Four voices of four hamlets round, from far and near, on mead and moor, swell out and fail as if a door were shut between me and the sound. Each voice four changes on the wind, that now dilate and now decrease. Peace and goodwill, goodwill and peace. Peace and goodwill to all mankind. This year I slept and woke with pain. I almost wished no more to wake, and that my hold on life would break before I heard those bells again. But they, my troubled spirit, rule, for they controlled me when a boy. They bring me sorrow touched with joy, the merry, merry bells of Yule. I wonder if you can relate or feel that way about how Christmas time, sometimes with the challenges of life, we struggle to relate to or experience again the joy that it once brought us. But I think he, in the poem, shares that the joy of Christmas is irrepressible. Well, I think for many of us, as we've noted before, this is a tough year. It's a tough winter. It's not easy for many people. Here in the UK, yes, a challenge, but also for many other places as well. But there are always reasons to rejoice. There are always things we can give thanks for, always ways that we can celebrate. And most of all, of course, the ultimate reason for the season, Jesus himself. For he brings many blessings to us. After all, this world, as we heard in the reading from John's Gospel, this world was created by him. All things were made by him and through him. All good gifts ultimately come from him. He's not just a baby born in a manger, but he is one with the Father and the Holy Spirit, the creator of all things and the source of all blessings. But he's also the light that shines in the darkness of the winter months and in the dark challenges of life in this world. He shines, and the darkness has not overcome or understood it, as the Bible reading says. He shines in the darkness, a light to guide us, to bring us peace and joy once again. for that is what Christmas is all about. Peace, joy, acceptance, family, love, these are all renewed at Christmas time. And most of all, through Christ. So let me just suggest to us this year, whatever our Christmas will be like, whether it will be quiet or whether it will be a very busy one, let us spend a little time together with someone we might not otherwise see. Could be someone new, someone different to the people we might normally spend time with, or someone familiar we just might not have the time or whatever it is to be able to see. Let us share some joy with them. However you choose to do it. It doesn't have to cost the earth. It doesn't have to be a large celebration. But just in a small way, share some joy with them. Maybe just gathering over a cup of coffee and a mince pie. Let's share some joy with one another. For ultimately, joy is built on relationships. Family, friends, those who might become friends. And as we gather together this Christmas time, I suggest let's raise a cup for Jesus and celebrate the gifts that he brings to us. Celebrate and raise a cup for him because he came that we might become part of God's family. As it says, to those who received him, who believed in his name, he gave the rights to be called children of God. May that acceptance, that relationship, fill us with joy this Christmas time. Amen. Thank you for joining us in this service today. Do join us again. We'll be live streaming our Midnight Communion service from St Mary's Church in Ingleton, so that will be available online over the Christmas weekend. And of course, do join us for services in church. Again, details on our website. And I look forward to seeing you again in the new year as well. But let's close our carol service with a prayer of blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.